I'm just saying, Gord. Dear friends, we give thanks for the gift of baptism for these people, one with us in the body of Christ, who are making public affirmation of their baptism. Let us pray. Merciful God, we thank you for Libby, Jennifer, and Kristen, whom you have made your own by water and the word in baptism. You have called them to yourself, enlightened them with the gifts of your Spirit, and nourished them in the community of faith. Uphold your servants in the gifts and promises of baptism, and unite the hearts of all whom you have brought to new birth. We ask this in the name of Christ.
Amen.
I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, reject sin, and confess the faith of the church. I invite the congregation to join in. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God?
Do
you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God? Do you renounce the ways of sin that draw you from God? Do you believe in God the Father? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? Public profession of your faith. Do you intend to continue in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, to live among God's faithful people, to hear the word of God and share in the Lord's Supper, to proclaim the good news of God in Christ through word and deed, to serve all people following the example of Jesus, and to strive for justice and peace in all the earth? People of God, do you promise to support Libby, Jennifer, and Kristen and pray for them in their life in Christ? That is, so we are going to say a prayer over all three of them, one at a time, and so invite the family to gather around Libby. Place a hand on her. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit you give us new birth. Cleanse us from sin and raise us to eternal life. Stir up in Libby the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and fear of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever.
Amen.
So I'll place our hand on each other. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit you give us new birth. Cleanse us from sin and raise us to eternal life. Stir up in Jennifer the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever.
Amen.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit you give us new birth, cleanse us from sin and raise us to eternal life. Stir up in Kristen the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence both now and forever. Amen.
Let us rejoice with these sisters and brothers in Christ.
We rejoice in the new lives of baptism. Together we will advance the grace of God and proclaim the good news to all the world.
Thank you. And now you all have confirmation verses.
I chose the passage Luke 11, verses 9 through 10, which says, "Asking ye shall receive the Lord's love," because it makes me think about my role in God's will. It reminds me that it is my duty and joy to seek the Lord as a child of God and an adult of the church, and to propel my own journey through faith. By opening doors through life, I can become fruitful in my daily efforts and happily foster my relationships with God and others around me.
My verse comes from Romans chapter 12, verse 21. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. This is important to my faith because many people go through life letting anger overtake them. Instead, you should be kind so that you are not overcome with evil.
My Bible verse comes from Psalms chapter 103, verse 12. Stop remembering what God has forgotten. This is important to my faith because you can't dwell on your past mistakes. Whatever sins you have committed doesn't define who you are. You have to forgive yourself because God has already forgiven you.
Give them a round of applause. Thank you all very much. I believe we have cake following. Do we have cake?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. We have cake. We're going to have cake.